We reached the coast, the ferry docks. I tried to organize and collect all the bags and objects spread in the cabin. I don't have time. The ferry leaves to take me back home. No holiday on the island. This was my recurring dream in the nights. And during the day, I can't stand small objects spread around the whole house. I can't recognize my body anymore. I'm not ready. No more chances for traveling. Stop performing, stop meeting, stop working, and of course, be alone with all this. Thousands of fears, but I was just very pregnant. When the time came, I decided to give birth at home, surrounded by my loved ones and friends. Not because I'm brave, rather the opposite. I feel hospitals terrorizing me, and I can't accept the idea that a stranger touched me. I've never felt so strong, so connected to life and death at the same time, and so focused. After this experience, the desire to talk about that power, that wild energy, began to grow in me. I decided to run an experiment in my city. I gathered some pregnant women to design a warrior dance with them, expressing how they felt, really, overcoming the cliché of the maternal body as sick, delicate and sweet. That was the beginning of the Duck March project, which took me, and often my daughter, to different parts of the world in order to meet and organize action groups of pregnant women. Despite the initial fears, now I travel more than before, my life is full, and yes, a bit more challenging. My motherhood was my inspiration. My daughter and the Duck March project are my masterpieces.